Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I am Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 3rd of January. India launches a drive to vaccinate children as COVID-19 cases spike. Pakistan reports highest number of daily COVID-19 cases in over 2 months. And hundreds of fans come together for annual cosplay fair in Nepal. And now for all the details. India has started vaccinating children aged 15 to 18 against the coronavirus as it quickly expanded its inoculation efforts to cover the world's largest adolescent population amid fears that the Omicron variant will drive a new surge of infections. The South Asian nation reported more than 33,700 new COVID-19 cases on Monday, while cases of the Omicron variant rose to 1,700, according to the Health Ministry.
India started vaccination for the age group of 15 to 18 years as the country witnessed an alarming surge of fresh COVID-19 cases. Thousands of children, many accompanied by parents, queued up outside schools, medical centers and special health camps to secure their first dose of vaccine. The country's largest cities, including New Delhi and financial capital Mumbai, have seen a huge spike in COVID-19 cases, including those of Omicron variant, which has triggered a fresh wave of infection in the other parts of the world.
मुझे बड़ा अच्छा satisfied feeling हो रही है क्योंकि vaccine हो गई है और सबको लगवानी चाहिए। नहीं मन तो नहीं था क्योंकि मेरी family members ने लगवाई थी तो उन्होंने कहा था कि कोई डरने की बात नहीं है, पता भी नहीं चलता कि कब लग जाती है vaccine और मतलब लोगों ने ऐसी बना रखा है कि ये होता है वो होता है।
In December last year, the Drugs Controller General of India granted accelerated approval to indigenous Covaxin for children above 12 years with certain conditions. Private and public schools will double up as vaccination centers for children and school authorities have been ordered to report their daily vaccination data to state authorities.
तैयारी अच्छी है और जिस हिसाब से अभी हम लोगों ने स्टार्ट किया है बच्चे अच्छे आने शुरू हो गए हैं तो हमें वैक्सीनेशन पूरी है सर हमें लग रहा है कि बच्चे
The UN Children's Agency UNICEF estimates India has the largest population of adolescents in the world, with about 253 million of them. Authorities reported 33,750 new COVID-19 cases and 123 deaths as of Monday. The total number of cases of the fast-spreading Omicron variant detected in India was 1,700, the Health Ministry said.
In news from Pakistan. Pakistan's Jamiat Ulema-e-Islam Fazl Chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman on Sunday, while speaking about his party's victory in the first phase of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa local body elections, said that the ruling PTI government will face worse defeat in the next phase. In an apparent reference to the army, which he blames for establishing PM Imran Khan's government, Rahman said they appeared to have a neutral stance in the local body polls, but they had interfered in the 2018 general elections.
Chief of Pakistan's Jamiat Ulema Islam Fazl Party Maulana Fazlur Rahman on Sunday while speaking about his party's victory in his first phase of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa local body elections said that Prime Minister Imran Khan's ruling PTI government will face worse defeat in the next phase. In an apparent reference to the army, which he blames for establishing Imran Khan as the Prime Minister, Rahman said, they appeared to have a neutral stance in the local body polls, but they had interfered in 2018 general elections to bring the PTI government. He expressed confidence that the ruling party will suffer a worse defeat in the second phase and the nation will prove that PTI's victory in the 2018 elections was fake.
2018 mein जो मुदाखरत इंतखाबी अमल में की गई और हम जिस दानली के ज़िम्मेदार उनको ठहरा रहे थे आज के इस बल्दियाती इलेक्शन में हमें वो न्यूट्रल नज़र आए हैं और उनकी न्यूट्रलिटी उसको हमने अप्रिशिएट भी किया है और देख भी लिया आप लोगों ने कि जब वो ज़रा गैर जानबदार होते हैं तो फिर नतायज भी इसी तरह सामने आ जाते हैं।
Meanwhile, Rehman, who is also the chief of the Pakistan Democratic Movement, announced that the multi-party opposition alliance will hold its long march toward Islamabad on March 23rd on Pakistan Day, as decided earlier. He urged the masses to join the anti-government march to oust what he termed as the illegitimate and incompetent government of Prime Minister Imran Khan. He further said that inflation in the country has made poor people's lives miserable, therefore it is now the entire nation's responsibility to help the country get out of the current situation.
Pakistan has recorded its highest number of COVID-19 cases in a single day since October 30, 2021, as 708 infections were detected during the last 24 hours, official data on Monday morning showed. Pakistan has reported 1.29 million confirmed cases of COVID-19 with 28,943 deaths so far. Asad Umar, Federal Planning Minister, called on citizens to take preventive measures and follow SOPs, wear masks and ensure complete vaccination if eligible. There is clear evidence now of a beginning of another COVID-19 wave that has been expected for the last few weeks. Genome sequencing had detected a growing number of cases of the Omicron variant, particularly in the largest city of Karachi, the minister said. Amid the rising threat from Omicron, Pakistan also began administering booster shots to citizens over 30 years of age from Monday onwards. Authorities said booster doses will be administered after 6 months' gap from last dose. Moving on. Activists in Pakistan-administered Gilgit-Baltistan have urged the government to take cognizance of the rapidly deteriorating healthcare situation in the region. In a recently held press conference in Gilgit City, the leaders demanded the authorities to increase bed capacity in government hospitals and maintain an unhindered supply of medicine stocks, unavailability of which, they said, has resulted in severe illnesses and deaths.
Healthcare in Pakistan-administered Gilgit-Baltistan is in dire straits, and the graph is rapidly heading south with each passing day, thanks to the apathetic administration, which has done nothing except lip service over the years. The government hospitals in Gilgit-Baltistan do not just have a deficit of modern machines and equipment, but they have also failed in providing fundamental-level treatment and medication to the patients. There is a shortage of residents, senior consultants, and even beds. In a recently held press conference, a group of rights activists urged the government to take immediate cognizance of the issue and work in the direction of resolving the crisis expeditiously.
Gilgit Baltistan ke tamam hospitalon samet Gilgit shehar mein maujooda tamam hospitalon ke halaat zar par raham kiya jaye. Adaviyat aur heading samet marizon ko tamam sahuliyat faraham ki jaye. Nayez Jagir Basin 30 bedded hospital ko upgrade karke 70 bed kiya jaye. جدید سہولیات سے آراستہ کیا جائے عرضی ملازمین ایکٹ 2020 پر عمل درآمد کو یقینی بناتے ہوئے مختلف سرکاری اداروں میں خدمات سر انجام دینے والے کنٹیکٹ پروجیکٹ اور کنٹیجنٹ پیڈ سٹاف کو فوری طور پر مستقل کیا جائے
پیپل آف دی ریجن بلیم دی لوکل گورنمنٹ وچ دے سے از نو شارٹ آف اے سٹوج آف اسلام آباد اینڈ دی آرمی اسٹیبلشمنٹ ہیز بین ڈیلیبریٹلی گیونگ دیم این اوورکل ٹریٹمنٹ They are denied their rights and the basic facilities in line with a carefully crafted Pakistani agenda of keeping them marginalized. Gilgit-Baltistan's geography and its topography make it vulnerable to natural hazards, which make it imperative to have a sophisticated health infrastructure. However, even after 7 decades of rule, Pakistan has failed in providing it with even basic level medical infrastructure.
India's Border Security Force recovered a huge haul of arms, ammunition and heroin near the border district of Samba in India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. India's bordering districts with Pakistan are notorious for smuggling and militant infiltration bids. The police said the foiling of the smuggling bid ahead of the country's Republic Day has averted a huge tragedy.
India's Border Security Forces on Monday foiled a smuggling bid and made a huge recovery of arms, ammunition and drugs in Samba district of Jammu and Kashmir territory near the border with Pakistan. The seized cache included AK-47 rifles, more than a dozen rounds of ammunition and 5 packets of heroin, among other weapons. The line of control, or the heavily militarized de facto border with Pakistan, is often used to funnel weapons and drugs in the volatile territory.
हमें सतत लगातार इनपुट मिल रहे थे पिछले कुछ समय से कि सीमा पार से इस प्रकार की घुसपैठ या तस्करी आर्म्स एमिनेशन या नारकोटिक्स की हो सकती है, उसके लिए प्रयास किए जा रहे हैं। तो उसके मद्देनज़र हमने अपनी जो सतर्कता बढ़ाई हुई थी और हम पूरी तरह से तैनात थे, और ये जो प्रयास किया गया था हमारी ट्रूप्स की तैनाती की वजह से ये विफल हुआ है।
Meanwhile, in a separate incident on Monday, security forces neutralized a militant in Srinagar city during an encounter. The slain militant, Salim Pare, was associated with Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Toyba terror outfit, and operations were still underway till the last reports came in, said the Kashmir police. India accuses Pakistan of supporting militancy in Kashmir. Islamabad denies this, saying it only provides diplomatic and moral support to the Kashmiri people.
And now for the comic lovers. Scores of fans of pop culture gathered for an annual cosplay fest in Nepal's capital Kathmandu this past weekend and showed off costumes of their favorite characters. The annual cosplay festival began in 2010 and has been growing over the years, bringing together pop culture elements such as anime and comics.
Hundreds of pop culture fans gathered at the comic and a fantasy festival in Nepal's Kathmandu this past weekend despite coronavirus threat. The annual cosplay festival Otaku Jatra started in year 2010 and has been growing over the years, bringing together pop culture elements such as anime and comic, according to organizer Abhinav Das Shrestha. Cosplay, which originated in Japan, is a combination of the words costume and play. In cosplay, people dress mainly as characters from Japanese anime, as well as graphic manga novels and video games. Participants were seen taking pictures with their favorite cosplayers and got their faces painted.
A very awesome feeling, because everything since we were a child, we have been looking at them through the screen. But when we see them in real life, it kind of feels like we are living our dream. It doesn't really feel like reality.
There has been a growing popularity of cosplay fans in recent years. Cosplay fans gather at a growing number of festivals around the world to show off their elaborate costumes, the product of hours of loving work, and enjoy their shared passion.
A one-of-its-kind pet show in India's Western Gujarat state drew animal lovers and pets from across the country. Apart from regular pets like dogs and cats, different kinds of birds, American iguanas, Macaw African grey, and other unique pets became the center of attraction in Navsari.
An animal welfare and rescue group organized a unique pet show for the first time in India's Navsari town on Sunday. Featuring different breeds of dogs, cats, fish and birds, the show also included American iguana, macaw, African grey, Toronto fish. The colorful pets also participated in a photo shoot. The organizers are involved in rescue operations of animals, including reptiles, snakes and injured birds. The pet show was an anomaly from their annual dog show in the area.
ये एनिमल सेविंग ग्रुप जो है हर प्राणी को बचाता है, तो यहाँ पे ज़्यादा करके हम लोग हर साल डॉग शो करते हैं। ये फर्स्ट टाइम है जो नवसारी में पेट शो हम लोग ऑर्गेनाइज़ कर रहे हैं, और पेट शो फर्स्ट टाइम ऑर्गेनाइज़ करने के बावजूद भी हम लोग को रिस्पॉन्स जो हाईली एक्सपेक्टेड नहीं था वो मिला है।
एज मैनी एज अबाउट 60 काइंड्स ऑफ पेट्स वर प्रेजेंट एट द शो एंड वर ऑल्सो गिवन अ फ्री मेडिकल चेकअप देयर. Some of the most unique pets also included 6-foot tadpoles, various species of spiders, and flying squirrels.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.